number of senior Pakistani government and military sources reportedly call it the biggest crisis in United States-Pakistan relations since the attacks of 9/11. This is bad today. We're told Pakistan has privately demanded that the United States Central Intelligence Agency suspend the drone strikes against militants in the territory there. Pakistan also reportedly calling for cuts to the number of U.S. Special Intelligence Operations personnel in the country. In other words, Pakistan is admitting what nobody's been admitting for years and years, and that's that we do have people on the ground. We've been telling you we do. Of course, the U.S. strategy for the war in Afghanistan hinges on going after militants taking refuge in the tribal regions of Pakistan. With us now from Berkeley, former California via Skype, Bob Baer, former CIA officer, case officer, who's watching this thing closely. Troubles with Pakistan does not bode well.
No, I think this is a catastrophe. You know, those people, there's some 350 of them, they're going to be asked to leave, are all there working on counterterrorism. They're looking for bin Laden, something the Pakistanis have been unable to help us with, find the guy and the rest of al-Qaeda, and it's their country. There is no excuse for this at all that I can see, and this war on terror is coming to a grinding halt.
I mean, they have a lot of problems over there internally, but the fact of the matter is they've never been able to or willing to participate in the tribal areas. They've been worried all along that internal strife is going to collapse their own government. We've worried about that because they have nuclear weapons. The whole thing is just a walking, talking disaster.
Oh, I think it is. Remember in 1979, they burned our embassy. A mob did, and the Pakistani army stood by and watched. I mean, it's almost like we're heading back to those days. And this, you know, the pretext for throwing these people out is the shooting of two Pakistanis. But what we should know...
Wait now. We can't just gloss over it like that. The pretext is not the shooting of two Pakistanis, but what they would say is the murder of two Pakistanis with people who were fleeing were shot in the back. That's their claim. I'm not saying that's what happened. I'm saying it's their claim.
You know, I'm the first one to jump on the CIA when it makes a mistake. But the point is these two guys showed guns. And this guy's training was to shoot him and kill him. There's no other way around it. It's an unfortunate incident. And also lingering out there is the fact that these two guys may have been hired by the ISI to harass Ray Davis. And, you know,
ISI, Pakistani intelligence, to harass Ray Davis. Go on with Ray Davis.
Yeah, that was, you know, as they say, a righteous shooting. You know, my wife was trained in that. I was trained in that. That's what you do, is when someone shows you a gun, you don't wait around and ask them whether they're robbers or what. So, you know, this is not a good call on the part of the Pakistanis at all.
Isn't this one of the risks that we run when we change you out of one uniform, put you into another, run you to a country where we're, quote, where we don't, quote, have boots on the ground, unquote, and yet we do have boots on the ground and we're doing what we do?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, we are there for a very good reason. I mean, bin Laden attacked the United States on 9/11. He's living in that country, as far as we know. The Pakistanis are unable to exert sovereign control over the tribal areas. So naturally, every administration, this isn't an ideological decision, has to have people there. And the CIA, if Pakistanis won't do it, we need to try on our own.
Bob Baer, live with us by Skype from Berkeley, a former case officer with the FBI. CIA, I should say. I'm sorry. Bob, great to see you. Thank you.